Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Serious Strategy Gamer, and we are returning to Hearts of Iron 4, where Operation Blau, unter Nehmen Blau, has resulted in the Spring Offensive of 1942, capturing a lot of Soviets. I think they're down to 93 divisions. Around 5 of these divisions are in this little pocket up here, and there's 5 further in this little pocket. So I'm thinking that they're going to probably be toast soon. We might even get a couple more encirclements here, so I think it is very likely that these guys are very soon going to find themselves, if not capitulating, then at least they're going to be effectively mission killed. I think they have very little capability to recover from this. So I think it is time for us to take a look back and take a look at the bigger picture here. So I think it is a time for us to focus on the Western Allies. The Western Allies are incredibly powerful. The United States have about 450 factories compared to our 370. So compared to that, they are vastly outnumbering us in material. They're also vastly outnumbering us in terms of divisions. They've got 800, we've got 500 if we are lucky. And I'm thinking they probably have a little bit stronger divisions too. So, how are we going to deal with that? Well, of course, we're going to focus on the Navy and the Air Force in the mid-run. Can we actually build up more raid installations? No. Okay, they are max level. We could be building one up here. That might not be the worst idea in Holland. But I think we are going to actually focus on building up that guy. We are going to continue to build these rail lines here that we have already started to establish. But I think we're actually going to dial that down a little bit. We're going to focus on the oil and synthetic refineries here. Not so much for the oil, really, but for the rubber. And then the next big quest is going to be, how are we going to deal with the Brits? Now, of course, we can try to invade the United Kingdom itself. That's going to be a tough fight. We'll need to establish air superiority there and do a lot of other things. But there's also the southern route. So if we think about Iran, about Persia here, it is adjacent to Iraq, which is neutral for now, but if we attacked Iran and Iraq, we could strike through here, through the desert, and into Egypt and this area. That might not be the worst idea. More importantly, though, I think we can try to invade the British Raj. I think there are probably going to be a lot of troops, especially probably down here on the border with Siam. Siam itself is neutral, but they are in the faction with the Japanese, so that should draw a lot of British troops here. And one of the big benefits of invading this area is rubber. There is rubber down here. There's certain other materials. So I think it would be a fantastic idea if we could actually try to get there. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to build up the rail line down there. So let's look at the construction, at the supply map. And then I think, I'm not entirely sure how we can do this. Ideally, so I'm thinking, well, that does make some sense, but I think we could potentially build it up more directly here, couldn't we? So yeah, let's build up these rail lines here, make sure that we've got a proper connection running to the south here, and then the big question is, do we set it up from here to the south, or do we accept that it's going to go there? I think we're going to accept that it goes here. That does mean we can a little bit use the existing rail infrastructure there. And then let's also start to build that up from here to here. Right, there we go. That's a lot of stuff to be built up, but I think it's going to be a good idea to have that line running down there. I would love for this to be a little bit better connected, but I think it's going to be alright. Where are you actually sourcing your supplies from? We don't know from here. Yeah, that's going to be alright. Okay, there we go. So, without further ado, let's resume the battle over here. Notice that we have a little bit of an encirclement going on here, on our side, but I think we're going to be alright if we attack here. That shouldn't be too worrisome. We've got a lot of troops here. Mostly out of supply, and I think we are losing a little bit of momentum. Soviets have at least managed to re-establish the front line a little bit, so that's good for them, but obviously kind of not that great for us. So question is, what can we do about that? I think one of the things that we might want to do is bring you guys a little bit further to the north here. We are striking here, so maybe we can do something else over there too. Let's just send you a little bit north. Maybe that's going to be useful. Right, and then we've got a couple of these Hungarian troops in particular. You guys should also move to the north here. Let's try to get you ready. You're sort of all over the place here, aren't you? Yeah. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure when exactly we're going to attack Iran, but probably we're going to not go into that this episode. And what I shall do, though, is give you guys here an order to prepare for attacking Iran. At least that should be okay. We do have a little bit of army experience. Let's actually take a look at our Alpenjäger divisions. Yeah, I think you can go at least with a cavalry recon regiment. I'm thinking about signal. Does that change? No, that doesn't change anything. Except it reduces piercing, increases supply usage. No, no, no. We're going to keep it as such. So that's going to be the new setup here. Let's also take a look at our medium panzers. So yeah, I think what we could do, so at least the Schwerer panzer, I think what I would like you to do is use the armored recon variant here. That does give you a little bit better armor, a bit better piercing, and all in all, it's not that bad. It does reduce reconnaissance a little bit, but honestly, it's not that bad. So I'm going to be happy with that. Same over here, you guys are also going to get that. Sorry, what is this? That's the medium panzer division. You have got an armor rating of 40. I thought that was a little bit lower. Oh well, happy about that then. So, yeah, it does change a couple of things here. Armor goes up, piercing goes up a little bit, breakthrough goes up significantly, defense goes down very significantly. Huh. Maybe that's not such a good idea. Ah, you know, we're gonna do it. Right, there we go. Okay, anything else? We've got the Stadtkämpfer guys here. We do kind of dig them, so very specialized unit, but we're going to see whether they're going to be useful. Oh, one more thing that I wanted to do is, I think if we do look at logistics, we do have quite a ton of naval bombers, actually. So let's set up a couple of these guys so that they can actually go ahead and fly all over the place. There we go. That's an airbase here. So how about we grab, like, 200 naval bombers. Tell you to go in the Bay of Biscay with naval strikes, obviously. Then we are gonna grab a couple. Shall we go to the English Channel? The English Channel is such a horrible area for you. Let's set up a couple of naval bombers here. Oh, I should also remember to tell you to only strike during the day. I think anything else is really... I don't know why that's not a default setting. It should really be a default setting. We are striking the Baltic Sea. I think we should also try to strike the Black Sea, I wanted to say earlier. But we should actually try to strike the naval... Jesus, words. So, we should actually try... Jesus. Okay, come on. Let me think here. 200 planes. Strike the upper Baltic Sea. Yeah, that's the one. There you go. Barents Sea should be fine. So I'm thinking that the Soviet Navy must be somewhere around here because we really haven't seen it in ages. So I think it must be somewhere around here. So do naval strikes during the day. You can do port strikes too, and you guys are doing that over here. Okay, let's see whether that is going to work out. What we can also do is take a look at the naval situation. Now, we are doing strikes over here. I think it might actually make sense to extend that a little bit towards a more comprehensive blockade of the British Isles over here. Let's see whether that is going to work. And lastly, you guys can do a little bit more of an aggressive attack pattern here. I would like that. Good, so without further ado, let's resume the game over here. Let's see what we're going to get. So there is... Is that already our next encirclement? No, it's not. But this over here is. So we've got these tanks all bunched up. Let's do finalize the attacks here. That would be great. You guys can break out a little bit. And you guys might want to go to Gorky and such. And other areas like that. Right, let's try capture that base too. Sorry, didn't we just... create another encirclement down here? I could have sworn there was another encirclement here. Well, I might be wrong. It has happened, I think. Right, guys, just continue to push into their lands, please, if you can at all. Let's bring you down here because there is another unit there, which I think we should try to overwhelm. Yeah, we're just going to continue to push a little bit. You guys can stop this attack. That's stupid. Right, and we are attacking up here. That's going to be alright, because I think ultimately we can defeat them if they continue to be situated over there. Right, guys, just push in a little bit here. I don't want to have these guys hanging around here the entire time. So let's simply try to overwhelm them a little bit here. You can certainly support this attack, can't you? At the very least, get some additional attack vectors in. Yeah, that's good, looking good. Right, you guys are doing fine here too. Let's do a little mini encirclement here. It's only single division, but you know what? Still alright. I'm going to be happy with that. Anything we can do over here? Well, this is a river. So, I think we're just going to try to do it like that. Again, small encirclements. At this point, they really don't have that many troops, so I'm going to be happy even with about small encirclements, because why not? Why not? Seems fine to me. One of you maybe get down here. Yeah, we do need to set up more troops all along the front line. But we are in pretty great trouble here, actually, with all of the supply issues that we're having. Maybe we can do something. Yours are getting ready down there, that's fine. Pilot promoted. While A's appears. North Atlantic Ridge. They have air superiority. No, there's a naval combat there. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that. Look at that indeed. We are sinking more convoys here. And we are seeing more enemy light destroyer groups and such. Why are you not attacking? Boom. Are you a coward or something? Boom. You're a lone wolf and a superior tactician. And we can get you to be a smokescreen specialist. That's not necessarily the best. Dönitz himself is torpedo cooldown, torpedo screen penetration, and submarine attack. Now, you obviously should be commanding the submarines, and you do, so that's K. Capital ship. No, capital ship is not what we need. Lutyens. I think Lutyens, my friend, you're going to be the new commander of this. We can actually take the guys that are operating up here in the Baltic Barents Sea and reassign you to this group and have more coverage over here. I think that's going to be a good idea. We've got these mine layer group, which is irrelevant, and Raider, aren't you also a good one? No, you're just the battleship guy. Yeah, and you're operating the Black Sea, that's fine. Oh, did we have more ships there? Seems like we had at least a couple of submarines here, yeah. Let's reassign you here. And you are going to go convoy raiding. As most of you are. Let's just double check whether we have misclicked yet at some point. No. You guys are all fine. Do your good work there. Ooh, notice how we are sinking more convoys here and doing port strikes. Now, we are losing ships in these port strikes, but aircraft in these port strikes. But we are doing so much damage that I think sooner rather than later they're going to lose ships. And once they are losing ships, I'm going to be a happy man. Right. Everything fine down there. You guys fine over here. And then we've bopped all of these guys there. Great. So, let's continue to focus on these areas here. Again, the faster we can get them to be overwhelmed here, I think the better. You actually are getting rid of that. That's good. Right, yeah, just cut that. Ooh. Well, some of these areas are really, really kind of awkward. Do you know what, guys? I think you can do this. So let's get you up here. Except one of you, and then except you. Yeah, I think we can close in all of these guys again. You guys are, I think, basically locked in. So let's continue these attacks here. Squeeze. And yeah, the Russians really should be suffering pretty badly here. Come on. I think you can actually attack him, overwhelm him, and that should be it for him. Slightly concerned about the position here, because we might have well outrun our positioning. But it seems to be fine so far, actually. So... Quit India movement. Ooh. Well, if you guys would be open to some other colonial power taking over, because I think that's exactly your idea here, isn't it? Let's try to capture that railway. Yeah, we are starting to be in a bit of an issue here, I think, where we are seeing that their rail lines are not even extending this far, so this might not work out great for us. Because we are coming into areas here where really there no one is going to have any supply. And that's not going to be good. Oh, we are getting more infantry equipment, yeah? Now that is great. There are a lot of things that I would do, but I think we are actually going to start here with the Marines, because at some point we will need some naval power like that. This is such a mess, and our supply lines are horrible, are actually just really, really horrible at this point. Okay, here's one thing that we can do. We can grab all of you guys, including you, including you. You're all going to get down here, except for like a single motorized division. Rest of you is going to move up there, except for a single motorized division. Do the same over here. That was a mistake. Okay, there's no way how I can select just you, is there? No, I think not. Okay, except you guys. Right, everyone go here. Except you. Go here. Except you. Go here. Except you. Here. Except for you. And so on. And so on. So you guys should well be able to come all the way down to Saratov. Yeah, I think that will work fine. And then you guys can actually try to get over here. Well, try to get over there, except for you. Or actually only you. That should work fine. And then you guys can get south here. Yeah, like that. That should be way within our capabilities. Fine, that's good. And then from the south here, we're going to take these blue guys and sort of push up like this. Except for motorized. Except for motorized. Except for motorized. Except for tank, because obviously tanks are the best thing to put into a city. So everyone knows, but yeah, there we go. So that should cut off at least a couple of further divisions down there. It's not going to be huge, but here we go. This is looking good. I like it. Oh, I like it. This is not bad at all. Okay, you guys have advanced there. Let's advance on these flanks here too. Good. Oh, we do have some pre-military factories. Well, that's lovely. Now, the biggest challenge that we are facing here is definitely fighters, which is a bit of an issue because we don't have enough stuff, especially in terms of rubber. Oh, Vichy, you can supply a little bit more at a horrendous cost, but yeah, that's the way it is. We're going to keep that as is. It's a shame how much we're paying for that, but... At least we are constructing more of these refineries, and that should help out at some point. I'm hoping, at least I'm hoping. Right, come on guys. Just smash through over here. Okay, we are seeing that these guys are now advancing, that's good. You guys should be able to get down there. Remember, they had 93 divisions at the start of this episode. I think that's going to be lower in just a moment. Interesting that these guys here have been sort of left behind the front line, actually. It's kind of odd, but I suppose it is. We have still broken their cipher. Ugh, Jesus. Okay, we need to adapt that a little bit. Guys, go ahead. Go ahead. Just go ahead and attack. Just do it. Don't leave our front line hanging like that. It's really not nice. You guys should all be okay. Port strikes? Let's actually check on that. They should be losing ships. Very soon they're going to lose ships. There we go. One destroyer. Submarines here being engaged by destroyers. That's no good. But further destroyers sunk. Convoy sunk. That's good. Americans losing a lot of convoys. British losing a lot of destroyers. That's really, really helpful. Convoys, convoys, convoys. Lots of battles up here. And our U-boats are doing specifically well. What's going on down here? Yeah, we're doing fairly well, I dare say. How about we take your group here and extend your operations to the North Atlantic Ridge too? So you're now trying to intercept there, aren't you? Yeah, as you should be. So you're coming up there, and are you now joining this fight? Yes, you are. That's great. Let's see whether you're actually going to make it into this fight. You are. And that means we've got now got 6 light cruisers engaged against 15 destroyers, 16 destroyers and a light cruiser. Let's see how well that is going to go for us. Well, we're sinking a couple of destroyers there. 6 destroyers sunk. 10 destroyers sunk. 11, 12. Okay, the light cruiser has gotten away, and a couple of the destroyers there have gone away too. But 14 destroyers sunk. Yes, please. Especially as that means their anti-submarine warfare capabilities are going to go down, and our submarines are going to have a gradually easier time as we are advancing here. Look at this. There's another nice encirclement here. Admittedly, mostly of terrain, but still. And admittedly, we have like zero capabilities to actually move in here because we don't have any troops down here. That's slightly awkward, but it's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright, isn't it? Yeah. And I mean, already at this point, they are getting fuel problems and such, so I'm gonna be happy about that. Right, speaking of being happy, let's take more victory points. That is gonna make me even more happy. Right, guys, just finish that off, please. You're doing fine over here. Now we can actually grab the rail line there, that's nice. Good. Guys, just advance. Advance, advance, advance. Look at all these little pockets. How ugly is this? Yeah, but we're going to be able to push in there. Let's make sure to get rid of all of these little tiny encirclements there. Agent captured. That's not good, because I think we already had a captured agent here. And I think their stuff is over here. Can I actually rescue you? No, we need more... More strength here. Okay, let's get everyone to Vladivostok. You are there already. And let's try to break out our operatives. Well, well, well. Okay, blue troops here. How about you try to overwhelm them? I think that's going to be the best choice here. And then we can try to push through, even though we are on horrendously low supply at this point. Just let's try to get there. Could work out. Could work. Every little bit of encirclement here will make me a happier man. You guys are going north there. Well, yeah, why not? But why not go south, huh? Close in on them. Can we, do we have any fast troops here? Not really. Not really any at all. Well, that's kind of odd. This is such a mess. This is really, I mean, how are you supposed to deal with front lines like that? Especially if you have a little bit of a compulsory disorder like I do, to actually have all everything neat. I mean, some of you guys know how min-maxy I can be, and this is not ideal at all, but we're just gonna roll with it. Not sure you guys up there are meant to do that. Let's advance it to the next victory point there. Right, you are advancing through here though, so that's great. You're advancing into there too, that's good too. Right, and you can actually try to overwhelm them there, or at least pin them in. So that you guys can come up there to the north. You guys are doing fine over here. Let's continue to push up into their rear here. We can also try at least to get towards Balanko. And you guys make your way up against these troops here. Just overwhelm them, please. Yeah, we're not gaining as much territory here because we're not doing this as, I want to say, coherently as we did before. But just look at all of this down here. How many divisions we have active in this theater here, or on that little bit of a front line. Right, let's attack you guys. Throw you back into these lakes. I'm not sure if throwing back is the right term if they've never been into these lakes, but you know what I mean. Right. Yeah, I think here too, this might work out. Little encirclements all over the place. Yeah, but if they don't have any troops here, it's basically what is going to happen. We're going to encircle all of them. There's really a critical amount of troops that you do need to have, otherwise your entire front line basically collapses, as we're seeing here, I think. Overwhelm them there. Get on the other side too. And how close are you to capitulating? Not really that close. We do need still a lot of victory points, and unfortunately, I think the next large amount of concentration of victory points for the Soviets is basically Vladivostok, and that means there's going to be a bit of a grind fest here, where we're basically defeating all of their units, and then we could have a free roll, but for some reason our armies are not even moving up. So there goes that. I should also really, really try to prioritize their airfields, actually, because, yeah, they had so many troops, so many air troops, so many planes, air troops, that they must really have problems trying to occupy all of these and sending them into the fight here. Yeah, I think we are going to be alright in much of the fighting, Simply because they don't really have any way to deal with this. Yeah, you're trying to capture the victory point there, that's great. Let's continue to roll up this ray line. And do our little mini encirclements. Yeah, here we go. Another promotion, good. Why are you not attacking here? I think you should officially be attacking, yeah. Okay, we can support this attack too. And once we have dealt with all of these guys here, we're gonna try to compare how many troops we now actually destroyed. So that should be it there. Okay, 1st of August. Bought this little thing. And more troops being encircled down here. Good, good, good. Right, come on, guys. Get down there. You already dealt with this. Let's try to get there. And very soon, I am expecting that we should see more victory points. There we go. There's another victory point province. You're trying to get this. Good. Swap you. Yeah, and at this, really, they don't have enough troops to present any coherent front line. And they're suffering so, so badly from that. The only thing that's saving them is that I don't want to micro, like, every little step everywhere. I'm feeling I'm doing that way too much already, but a little bit, you just need to do it. Because look at what the AI is otherwise going to do. Recon Company 3 done, that's good. That does give us more reconnaissance, obviously. Now, I think probably the best choice is going to be, well, we do have the advanced fire control system. Let's go for the advanced computing machine for the 8% research speed. We do need to catch up a little bit on naval stuff. So I would love to do that a little bit faster, but we're going to do it this way. And here we go, this guy is done for. Let's take a look then at the Soviet situation and see how many troops they actually do have left. I'm guessing it's not going to be a lot. It can't be a lot. They just have troops here and there. And we might actually draw back most of our infantry here. Just keep it to the motorized divisions, really. I don't even think we need the tanks. So, yeah, let's take a look. So, last time around, we thought 93 divisions. They now have 40. So, we halved their troops again. They only have 300,000 manpower deployed. That's nothing. That 40, that's like two of our armies. And it doesn't even count like this guy who's almost dead. He doesn't know it yet, but he is. That guy might be overrun. Two more up here. Yeah, it's really, they can't really hope to get away with that. So we'll need to reorganize all of that, but it's going to take a moment. And after that, we're also going to set up a cooperation. Ooh. I want to hit that button. I don't exactly know what it does. Whether it does in fact anything other than give us a new shade of... oh, look at this. Ha, huh, I knew it. I knew you'd be there somewhere. Look at all of this. Okay, Soviet submarines in the Bay of Biscay. Get it. More destroyers sunk. Lovely. 14 convoys sunk. I think we are seeing the effects of them losing so many of their escorts that also their convoy losses start to spiral up. There was another 11. That's 6 convoys. So if they really suffer so much from... Is that Soviets here? Yeah. Okay, so here we can sink you, but we couldn't sink you up there in the Barents Sea. That's odd, at least. 8 more convoys sunk there. That is nice to see. I don't think we know anything about their situation really. Our intelligence on them is really small. We know a little bit about the ship count. Do we know anything about your convoys? Cattle ship production. I don't think we know how many convoys you actually have. We only know how many you lost and you are producing, allegedly. Factories used in trade. Well, I can't see any intel, so maybe I'm blind, but how's our shipping doing? Another couple of, ooh, there we go, light cruisers, that's lovely. You're gonna be assigned to that, and these two are gonna be assigned to, and these two are gonna be assigned to that. Ah, you're currently battling, so that's why that is not something that we can do right now. Yeah, now that should work. Okay, there we go. Okay, we do need to be a little bit mindful about the air situation here too. They are sending us bombers to B-23s, bombers. So yeah, I think it really is our fighter production that we need to focus on. But there's only so much that we can do about that. Ooh, this is nice. It's good to see that we don't need as much stuff here from some of our allies and trade partners, because apparently we do now have more of that ourselves, which is great to see. One thing I'm debating of doing is go back to extensive conscription. We do have the, you know what, let's do it. And we're gonna see whether that is gonna hurt our manpower too much. I don't think we need to be too concerned. We can, for example, disband these guys here because we don't really need cavalry anymore. That should be okay. Yeah, there we go. Get rid of you. And basically, I think we might have enough population to sustain our fight and focus a little bit more on outputting material. Look at the amount of convoys they are losing. I'm happy about this Battle of the Atlantic. So, that being said, it is time to put in a cut. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Do leave a like and all of that, and I'll see you around next time.